What I'm about to go over is going to feel very basic and you may be tempted to skip it, but please do not. Knowing this basic concept will do wonders for your understanding in chemistry and will save you from making a lot of common mistakes. Now, let's review two basic math terms. A multiple is the result we get from multiplying two whole numbers together. The least common multiple is the smallest multiple that is common to two or more numbers. For example one, we are asked to find the least common multiple of 2 and 3. To find the least common multiple, start with finding the multiples of each number. To find the multiples of 2, we would simply multiply 2 times different whole numbers like these. So 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 4 is 8, and so on. Do the same thing for our other number, which is 3. So 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 2 is 6, 3 times 3 is 9, 3 times 4 is 12, and so on. Now that we've found our multiples of each number, we'll look for the smallest number that both lists of multiples have in common. The smallest number both lists share is 6. Thus, 6 is our least common multiple. Go ahead and try this next example out on your own. Let's go over the answer. We'll start with finding the multiples of each number. So 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 4 is 8, and so on. We'll do the same thing for our other number, which is 4. So 4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 4 times 3 is 12, 4 times 4 is 16, and so on. Both lists have a 4 and an 8. But we are looking for the smallest number that both lists have in common. Therefore, our least common multiple is 4. There are two main chemistry topics where knowing how to find the least common multiple will be very helpful. These topics are naming compounds and redox reactions. Let's start with naming compounds, which is also referred to as nomenclature. You will typically be asked to write the chemical formula from the compound name. We specifically will use the least common multiple to help balance charges. And you only balance charges for ionic compounds. An ionic compound consists of a metal and a nonmetal, where metals have positive charges and nonmetals have negative charges. For charges to be balanced, they must be the same number but have opposite signs. Let's find the least common multiple using the charges as our numbers. We'll start with finding the multiples of each number. So 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6. Do the same thing for the 3. So 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 2 is 6, and we can stop here since both lists have a 6, and that is the smallest number that both lists have in common, thus 6 is our least common multiple. This means that we want both charges to be 6. To balance charges, we add subscripts to the element that needs its charge to change. In this example, we want both charges to change to 6, so the subscript for iron will be 2, because for this charge of 3 to become 6, it needs to be multiplied by 2. Same concept goes for the oxygen. The subscript for oxygen would be 3, because for this charge of 2 to become 6, it needs to be multiplied by 3. We just found our chemical formula, and note, we do not include charges. The charges are there to help determine the subscripts of the chemical formula. Here's another example, where we again need to balance the charges to find the new subscripts of the chemical formula. Let's find the least common multiple using the charges as our numbers. We'll start with finding the multiples of each number. So 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4. Do the same thing for our other number of 1. So 1 times 1 is 1, 1 times 2 is 2, and we can stop here since both lists have a 2, and that is the smallest number that both lists have in common, thus 2 is our least common multiple. This means we want both charges to be 2. Again, to balance charges, we add subscripts to the element that needs its charge to change. In this case, only one element needs to change since the calcium already has a charge of 2. So the only element that needs a subscript is the chlorine. We'll place a 2 subscript on chlorine because for this charge of 1 to become 2, it needs to be multiplied by 2. This is our chemical formula. All right, how about you try this one on your own using the same steps we went over? If you said Pb2O4, you just made a common mistake, and this is exactly why finding the least common multiple will help you avoid making this mistake. So let's find the least common multiple using the charges as our numbers. We'll start with finding the multiples of each number. So 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4. Do the same thing for our other number of 4. So 4 times 1 is 4, and we can stop here since both lists have a 4. This means we want both charges to be 4. Again, to balance charges, we add subscripts to the element that needs its charge to change. In this case, only one element needs to change, since the lead already has a charge of 4. So the only element that needs a subscript is the oxygen. We'll place a 2 subscript on oxygen because for this charge of 2 to become 4, it needs to be multiplied by 2. And this is the correct chemical formula. Now, do you have to go through these steps every single time and find the least common multiple? No. If you do this enough times, you will be able to balance these charges in your head, which should be your goal. The main thing I want you to understand is how we figure out the subscripts for the chemical formula. But if for any reason you aren't sure, then I do recommend finding the least common multiple first. The second chemistry topic that uses a least common multiple is in redox reactions. Redox reactions are a type of reaction where electrons are being gained and lost between two reactants. A redox reaction undergoes two processes at the same time. The first process is oxidation, which is the loss of electrons. And the second process is reduction, which is the gaining of electrons. We use something known as oxidation numbers or oxidation states to help us determine which reactant undergoes oxidation or reduction. Note, how to find oxidation numbers will be explained later in this learning playlist. When balancing redox reactions, there is a step where you need to balance the electrons of the half reactions. Note, a redox reaction can be split apart to show each process. These are called half reactions, where we only show the elements or chemical species involved in oxidation and in reduction. We find our electrons from the oxidation numbers. We subtract the product's oxidation number by the reactant's oxidation number of the same element. That's how we got our 3 electrons for oxidation and our 2 electrons for reduction. And it's fine that this is positive. Electrons are already negatively charged. We are only looking for the positive values. We'll place the electrons for oxidation on the product side of the half reaction, while the electrons for reduction go on the reactant side. Now it's time to use the least common multiple to help us balance these half reactions. We want the electrons to be the same number. Let's find the least common multiple using the electrons as our numbers. We'll start with finding the multiples of each number, so 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 2 is 6. Do the same thing for our other number of 2. So 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6, and we can stop here since both lists have a 6. This means that we want both electrons to be 6. To balance the electrons, we will multiply the entire half reaction by 2, because for these 3 electrons to become a 6, we need to multiply them by 2. Same concept goes for this other half reaction. We will multiply by 3 for these 2 electrons to become a 6. We'll distribute the 2 to each coefficient. If there is no coefficient, then assume it is 1. And this is our new half reaction for oxidation. Do the same thing for reduction. Distribute the 3 to each coefficient, and here's our new half reaction for reduction. Add both half reactions together to get our balanced redox reaction. And you'll know if you did this correctly if the electrons are the same, are on opposite sides, and cancel out. This is our balanced redox reaction. I've seen so many students struggle with this because they simply don't practice. That's why I've made it so much easier for you to practice along with me. Head over to melissa.help/practice to find practice problems specifically for what you just learned. And once you get through them all, come back for the next video.